Okay, should we have to be quiet?
Probably about 20 seconds.
Okay, stay quiet. Everyone's going to smile. Make a funny face. It's hot in here. Whew. You ready, Christy? Ready? Welcome to Storytime at the Berkshire Athenaeum Children's Library. I'm Valerie Toner. You know what we're going to do today?
Yeah.
We're going to talk about everybody is different and everybody is special. You know that? Some of us have brown hair. Some of us have blonde hair like Sarah. Some of us have red hair like Corey. And some of us have really dark hair like Jesse up there. Hi, Jesse. Okay, everybody is different. And that's our first story. Everyone is different. Some are short. Do you know a short person?
No.
No? Nobody this short?
I'm a short person.
You don't know?
I'm a short person.
Who?
Little Danny.
Little Danny?
Well,
I know a short person.
Who do you know, Corey?
My brother.
Your brother Jay. Yeah.
I know a short person.
Well, if we have a short person, you know what we need?
What?
A tall person. This person is so tall, it didn't fit on the page. What do you see there?
Legs.
And what else?
Feet.
What color are his feet?
Red.
Oh. Some are thin. He's got a shirt and pants on and some shoes. And what's this thing right here?
A bow tie.
Well, if some people are thin, some are what? What is this?
Elephant.
It's an elephant. Are most elephants thin?
No.
No. What are they?
They're all big.
They're all big. That's right.
They carry.
Yeah. Some people are shy. What is this guy doing?
He's hiding.
Hiding behind what?
A flower pot.
He's afraid to come out. Well, if some people are shy, some people are not.
Some people are funny.
Funny. Look at the hair. What color is the hair?
Red.
Red. And look at the shoes.
Red.
This looks like a ballerina.
Yeah.
A clown ballerina, right?
Yes.
Some are purple.
That's not purple.
Yes.
Red.
That's purple.
And red.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Well, what is this thing?
A cat.
A cat. How can you tell it's a cat? Whiskers, that's right. Well, if some people are purple, some people are not. What colors do you see there?
I see red.
You see red?
Purple.
Oh, what is this thing?
A pig.
A pig. Have you ever seen? Have you ever seen a polka dotted pig?
No.
Well, now you have. Some people are sad all the time.
You can record that guy.
Can you make a sad face? Who can make the saddest face? Jesse can make the saddest face. And some people are happy all the time. How many smiley faces do we have? One. Six smiley faces. Everyone give us a smile. Let's see some teeth. Let's see some teeth. Oh, Mallory's missing a tooth. Okay, but no matter who you are, who is this?
An angel.
No matter who you are, you are special You are different, and everyone loves you just the way you are. Did you like that?
Yeah.
Okay, now we have to stand up, and you have to do everything I do, okay?
Yeah.
I have 5 fingers on each hand. Can you help me count?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All together, how many do you have?
10.
Can you count to 10? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I've got 10 fingers. I have 2 ears. I have 2 eyes. I have 1 nose. I have 1 mouth. My hands can clap. Okay, my feet can jump. Okay, my eyes can wink. Let's see you wink. Let's see you wink. Good. My nose can smell. One more time. And my ears, what do my ears do?
Hear.
They can hear. And what does my mouth do? Does it sing too?
Yeah.
Who knows if you're happy and you know it?
I do.
Everybody? Who's going to help me sing it?
Me.
Okay, on the count of 3. You going to help me count to 3?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, jump up and down. If you're happy and you know it, jump up and down. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, jump up and down. If you're happy and you know it, wiggle your ears. If you're happy and you know it, wiggle your ears. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, wiggle your ears. If you're happy and you know it, touch your nose. If you're happy and you know it, touch your nose. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, touch your nose. If you're happy and you know it, make a smile. If you're happy and you know it, make a smile. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, make a smile. Very good. Okay, let's everyone sit down. Okay, now we're going to meet a little boy who changes into different animals. How does that sound?
Good.
His name is John. Just only John. And there he is right there. And can you see what these animals are? What's this?
Elephant.
And what's this?
Giraffe.
And what's that?
Lion.
And what's that?
A pig.
And what's that?
A rabbit.
And what's this little guy?
A mouse.
Okay, this is a hard one. What's this?
A lamb.
And who's this hiding behind? I bet you can't guess.
Kangaroo.
Who said kangaroo?
I did.
Well, you're right. It is a kangaroo.
I did.
Good for you. You're smart. Just only John. What's this?
Frosty.
A snowman?
Yeah.
Frosty? Yeah. Once upon a time, a long time ago, if you count Sundays and holidays, there was a little boy named John. He had been a little boy named John for over 4 years, and he was getting tired of it. Not that it wasn't a nice thing to be, but sometimes he wondered what it would happen to be like something else. How would you like to be something else? What would you like to be?
I would like to be a lion.
A lion?
I'd be a tiger.
A tiger?
I'd be an elephant.
Nathan, what do you want to be? Okay, let's find out what happens to John. Here we go. Sometimes on Thursday afternoons, if the weather was nice, he wondered what it would be like to be an elephant named Guster who worked at the circus. What do you think an elephant eats for breakfast?
Peanuts.
And sometimes on Tuesdays, after his nap, he wondered what it would be like to be a giraffe named Elmer, or maybe George, or Melvin, or Jim. One day, when John was wondering what it would be like to be a kangaroo named Sam, he got an idea. I know what I'll do. I'll pretend. And if I pretend, I'll know what it's like to be a real kangaroo. So he spent the whole morning pretending to be a kangaroo who liked hot dogs and soda pop. You think kangaroos like popcorn?
No.
Hot dogs?
No.
Soda pop?
No.
Pizza?
No.
And he spent the whole afternoon wondering whether it was the bounces or the hot dogs that gave him such an awful tummy ache. You think it was the hot dogs?
Yeah.
You can't find out what it's like to be something just pretending. You have to be the real thing.
I know, because animals sometimes don't get a headache.
They don't get a headache?
He's wiggling the lamp.
Uh-oh, okay. Look at, who's this?
A witch.
Does that look like a witch? Suddenly, John remembered Mrs. Walpurgis, who did witchcraft and hem stitching the other side of the block.
Was
she bad? Nope. On the counter in Mrs. Walpurgis' shop were big glass jars filled with penny magic spells for turning people into a wide variety of interesting things. What do you think is going to happen to John when he takes one of those? What do you think, Sarah? John picked out a peppermint-flavored magic spell and gave Mrs. Walpurgis his penny. He didn't ask what the spell would turn him into because he didn't want to spoil the surprise, but he hoped he wouldn't be turned into a fierce animal. What's that?
A lion.
He was a little bit afraid of fierce animals. You know what's going to happen? When he got home, he peeked to see what he had turned into. Why, he said, it's just only me. And that's what he was. I guess it takes a while to turn into something with a magic spell, said John, and he hoped it would happen before bedtime. He didn't want to miss it by being asleep. Oh, there you are, said John's mother. Where has my little lamb been? Uh-oh. She called him a lamb. What do you think's going to happen? You're right. She no sooner called him a lamb than John turned into one. It was that sort of a magic spell. His mother was rather surprised when John turned into a lamb. What happened to you, bunny? She said. But John didn't answer. She called him a bunny.
Bunny.
He had turned into a bunny and he wasn't quite sure, being new at it, what kind of a voice a bunny would use. Stop that this instant, said his mother. And she called him John. And guess what? He turned back into John. No sooner had she called him John than John was John again. And he felt more comfortable that way, since that's what he was used to being. He told his mother all about the magic spell, and they agreed that they had to do something, because John didn't want to turn into animals for the rest of his life. They decided to go ask Daddy. Daddy was at the office, and on the way there, John's mother gave him some jelly beans. He had had such a hard day that the jelly beans tasted good. "Eat them nicely," said his mother. "Not like that," she said. "What do you think you are, a little pig?" Uh-oh. Well, it's rather embarrassing to turn into a pig at 3:30 in the afternoon at the corner of Main and Elm Street. And there's John. Look at how surprised these people look. "You're not a pig," said John's mother quickly. "You're John." And he was. Daddy was a very important man with his own office and his name on the door. "Well, well," said John's daddy. "How's my little man today?" Uh-oh. What happened? Turned into a little man. And while he was turning into a little man, John's mother explained about the magic spell. "It comes from wanting to be something else," said John's daddy. "I know it's better to be me," said John, "but I just wanted to try out the magic spell, and now I have to live with it for a long time. What should I do?"
"Give it back."
"Give it back?"
"Yeah. Put it back in the jar."
"Little man, don't cry," said Daddy. "The magic spell won't bother you if you just remember to be you." So John kept repeating, "I'm just only John."
And he turned back into John.
And he did, look. And he was, and probably still is. And the moral of the story is, be yourself, because somebody has to, and you're the closest. Did you like that story?
Yeah. Yeah, but where were all the animals?
Oh, he turned into a few. What did he turn into, a pig? And he pretended to be a giraffe. And what didn't he want to be?
A kangaroo.
Oh, the kangaroo made him sick, didn't it? He didn't want to be a lion.
No.
Okay, now everyone's going to do what I do, right?
Yeah.
Show me one hand. Wiggle one finger. Wiggle one ear. Touch one nose. Stand one body up. Okay, show me two hands. Wiggle two fingers. Wiggle two ears. Touch two eyes. Touch one nose. Give me one smile. Now sit one body down. Very good. How many of you know a shy person? You're shy? Oh, I find that hard to believe that you're shy. Jesse, are you shy? How many of you are shy?
I'm not.
How many of you aren't shy?
I'm not.
Well, we're going to meet a person who's very, very shy. So shy that he jumps into bags of flour when he doesn't want to say goodbye. How many of you know Shy Charles?
Not me.
Not you?
Not me.
What is this thing?
A mouse.
A mouse. Who said mouse? Joshua said mouse. It's a mouse. And this is his mother, and this nice lady is trying to give him a piece of cake, but look at what he's doing. He's hiding behind his mother.
Shy.
He's very shy. Yes. Can you see that he's hiding behind this flower pot?
Yeah.
How can you tell? You can see his tail. That's right. There he is, and what's he doing?
Roller skating.
Roller skating.
Fat belly.
Charles was as happy as he could be.
Fat.
He's fat. Yep, he's a little chubby. But he liked to play alone. He wouldn't even talk to Wanda Sue. And he never went near the phone. "It's a new day," said Charles's mother. "Let's go in the store and say hello. We'll buy a sweet potato pie. And we'll say goodbye before we go." Doesn't that sound good?
Yeah.
Yeah. Wonderful morning, said Mrs. Belinsky. A chocolate surprise for my beautiful boy? Look, there he is. Does he look shy? Say thank you, whispered Charles's mother. Thank you, yelled Mrs. Belinsky. Enjoy. His mother told him to say goodbye. Charles hid inside a flour sack. Goodbye with kisses, said Mrs. Belinsky. Someday when he's big, he'll say goodbye and give me a kiss. I'm so embarrassed, said Charles's mother. You never say goodbye. You never say thank you. Lucky for you, I'm your mother. Any other mother would spank you. This can't go on, said Charles's dad. I'm sick and tired of thank you fights. It's time you played football or joined the ballet. Next Tuesday, Charles was in tights. Does he look cute in those tights?
No.
Oh, I think he does. Isn't he sweet? Cried Madame LaFleur. Charles wouldn't say maybe, he wouldn't say yes, and he wouldn't say no. For a week, he pretended to be asleep. Can you see Charles in the picture? You see him over here sound asleep?
Yeah.
And everyone else is having fun dancing? Well, Charles was not a big success. So Charles's father took him to town and bought him some beautiful football things. The shirt was scarlet with shoulder pads, and the helmet had silver wings. Charles said his father, "You'll be the best. Like lightning, you'll streak across the grass. Like butter, you'll melt the defensive line. You'll throw the winning pass." Does that sound like Charles? Charles trembled like an autumn leaf. "Hi," roared the coach. "My name is Fred. He doesn't look too well to me. You better take him home and put him to bed." Poor Charles, he's shy. Charles, said his dad, "you're like a jelly roll. You're just like a cowardly custard. You're like sandwich without bread, not to mention ham and mustard. Now how will you go to school? How will you get a job? How will you get married?" Charles sat down and started to cry so hard that he had to be carried all the way home. Then Charles's father murmured low, "A babysitter is coming tonight. You know the one. It's Mrs. Block, and everything will be okay." The sun went down, the setter came, and his parents left at 6 o'clock. Charles skedaddled up the stairs. "Come back, little pushcake," cried Mrs. Block. "Is Charles going to come back?" He's too shy. Charles played happily in his room. He made a spaceship out of chairs. And then suddenly, there was a big crash. Mrs. Block had fallen downstairs. What is Charles going to do? He has to save her. Charles got her to the sofa. He told her, "Now don't be nervous." He brought her a blanket and some hot chocolate, and then he called the emergency service.
Why?
Because she's fallen down and she needs help. "He saved my life," said Mrs. Block. "He's a prince. He's a gem. He's a hero." And everyone shouted, "Thank you, Charles."
He's a hero.
But you know what?
What?
Charles said, "Zero. Where is he?"
Right there.
He's hiding inside his mom's coat. He's awfully shy, isn't he?
He's not shy anymore.
How How about doing some morning stretches with me? You ready? Reach to the stars. Reach to the stars. Wiggle your fingers.
Let's play twinkle, twinkle, little star.
Okay, we'll do that after we do our morning stretch. How's that? Can you bend over and find your toes? Can you find your knees? Can you find your waist? Can you find your belly? Can you find your nose? How about your ears? Okay. Now, Corey wants to sing Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. Would you like to do that too?
Yeah.
Okay, let's. Okay, afterwards we'll do that. You ready? On the count of three. One, two, three. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Okay, how about, here we go around the mulberry bush. Do you know that? Okay, everyone stand up. Let's stand up and sing that one, okay? Here we go round the mulberry bush, the mulberry bush, the mulberry bush. Here we go round the mulberry bush so early in the morn. This is the way we brush our teeth, we brush our teeth, we brush our teeth. This is the way we brush our teeth so early in the morning. This is the way we comb our hair, we comb our hair, we comb our hair. This is the way we comb our hair so early in the morning. This is the way we scrub our face, we scrub our face, we scrub our face. This is the way we scrub our face so early in the morning. This is the way we put on our boots, we put on our boots, we put on our boots. This is the way we put on our boots so early in the morning. This is the way we sit back down, we sit back down, we sit back down. This is the way we sit back down, we sit back down, we sit back down. This is the way we sit back down, we sit back down, we sit back down so early in the morning. Very good. Who wants to see an ugly beast?
Me.
You do?
Yeah.
Is this ugly enough for you? Oh, it's not that bad. What color is he?
Green.
Green.
Favorite color.
And what does he have over his head?
A bag.
A bag.
Yeah.
You think he's so ugly he needs a bag over his head?
Yeah.
No.
Oh, there he is. Who's gonna be the quietest person? There was a time when Beast thought he was ugly. He thought his ears were too big. And he thought his nose was too big. He thought his ears were too big. And he thought his belly was too big. He thought his feet were too big, and his tail was much too long. So he bought a hat to cover his ears, and some sunglasses to cover his eyes. Does he look better now?
Yeah.
You think so? He bought a scarf to hide his big nose, and an apron to hide his big belly. And some big red shoes to hide his big feet. And then he got some string and he tied his tail so that it would look shorter. Now doesn't he look beautiful?
Yeah.
Now Beast thought he was beautiful. And he decided to visit some of his friends. First he saw Rabbit. Why are you hiding your ears? Asked Rabbit. Big ears are beautiful. So the Beast gave his hat to the Scarecrow. Then he saw Fly. Why are you hiding your eyes? Asked Fly. big eyes are beautiful. So the beast gave his glasses to the scarecrow. Then he saw the anteater. "Why are you hiding your nose?" asked anteater. "Big noses are beautiful." So guess who got the scarf?
The scarecrow.
Then he saw the bear. And the bear asked, "Why are you hiding your belly? Big bellies are beautiful." Who got the apron?
The scarecrow.
Then he saw Duck. "Why are you hiding your feet?" asked Duck. "Big feet are beautiful."
You were
giving
the scarecrow.
That's right. He gave those sneakers to the scarecrow.
Then he saw,
who's this?
An alligator.
And the alligator asked, "Why are you hiding your long tail? Long tails are beautiful." So the scarecrow got some new string for his shirt. And you know what? The beast looked just the way he was before. And he wasn't ugly anymore. Now,
he's
beautiful. Do you think he looks beautiful? Yes.
The flies on his balloon.
We know sometimes when we feel sad and we don't think very highly of ourselves, we have to give ourselves a hug. So we have to learn a new song that we can take home and teach to mom and dad and our brothers and our sisters and our cats and our dogs, okay? We have to stand up and learn this song.
I got a dog.
Okay, we have to stand like this. Can you stand like this? Now with a deep voice you have to say, "Hug a hug a hug." Oh, let's hear it really loud. Let's hear it. Hug a hug a hug. Oh, good. Now with a really high voice like this, you have to say, "Give me a squeeze." Oh, I can't hear you.
Give me a squeeze.
Okay, now what do you have to do when you're like this? Hug a hug a hug. Oh, let's hear it again. Hug a hug a hug. Give me a squeeze. Okay, we have to sing that three times. You ready on the count of three? One, two, three. Hug a hug a hug. Give me a squeeze. A hug a hug a hug. Give me a squeeze. A hug a hug a hug. Give me a squeeze. Please. A hug and a squeeze. Should we try it one more time? Give me a squeeze. A hug a hug a hug. Give me a squeeze. A hug a hug a hug. Give me a squeeze. Please. A hug and a squeeze. Very good. You were very good today. Should we wave goodbye? Wave goodbye. Bye-bye. See you again. Okay, good. Whoops. Careful.
Okay.
Hey, watch the corner.
Yep.